Welcome to the CHRS Absence Management Tutorial on how employees can cancel absences and edit and resubmit absences, particularly if they receive an error indicating that there is an existing absence with the same start or end dates when requesting a new absence. You can use the topics in the notes for this video to jump to specific sections within the video. Closed captions are available for this presentation. Click on the CC icon in the play bar to enable closed captions. Here you can see that I've gotten an error that the start and end dates of my absence overlap with an existing absence. You may also see similar errors that indicate that the start or end dates are the same as another absence. Let's click View Requests to find the absence request that is causing the error. Click No to discard your current absence request. Locate the absence request that includes the same dates as the absence request you are trying to create. In this example, the new absence request that I was trying to create included dates that are in the denied vacation request. If the absence causing the error is marked as denied or pushback or canceled, you can click on the existing request, edit it, and then resubmit it. We'll look at editing an existing absence now, and then later look at what to do if the absence is marked as approved or submitted. Let's click on the absence to edit it. Now I'll just modify this absence request to match the new absence I wanted to create. You can modify pretty much any field, so you can change it from a vacation request to a sick leave request, for example. In this example, I just need to change the dates of the absence. Now I'll click Forecast. Click OK when it is successfully forecasted. If you don't have enough leave credits to cover the absence, contact your timekeeper or payroll for assistance. If you get an error with the forecast, you can try submitting the absence, but your timekeeper or payroll may also need to assist with that. Click Submit to submit the updated absence request. Click Yes. The updated absence is submitted. You'll get an email when the absence request is approved by your manager. If the absence is marked as approved or submitted, you will need to cancel the absence, and then you will be able to edit it and resubmit it. Click on Cancel Absences. Click on the absence you want to cancel. Click Cancel Absence. Click Yes. Your cancellation request is submitted. If the absence was marked as approved, your manager will need to approve the cancellation, and then you will be able to edit it. If the absence was marked as submitted, the absence will be canceled immediately. Click CSU Time to go back and edit the absence. Click View Requests. Select the newly canceled absence request. Now I'll just modify this absence request to match the new absence I wanted to create. You can modify pretty much any field, so you can change it from a vacation request to a sick leave request, for example. In this example, I just need to change the dates of the absence. Now I'll click Forecast. Click OK when it is successfully forecasted. If you don't have enough leave credits to cover the absence, contact your timekeeper or payroll for assistance. If you get an error with the forecast, you can try submitting the absence, but your timekeeper or payroll may also need to assist with that. Click Submit to submit the updated absence request. Click Yes. The updated absence is submitted. You'll get an email when the absence request is approved by your manager. Thank you for viewing this tutorial. Please see the notes for this video for links to training guides and resources.